Hey guys, welcome to another Q&A session from the Reaper blog. These questions came in from the Facebook group, Reaper blog community. I have a lot of great conversations there, and these are some of the topics that have come up over the last few months. Before we get into that, I want to thank all of my patrons and all of my viewers, everyone that has liked and subscribed and shared the videos. It means a lot to me. I just want to get these videos out there and seen by as many people as possible. So if you have not subscribed, please hit that subscribe button, and then you can be notified about when I go live and things like that. So thanks again. All right, let's get into the Q&A. First question comes from Snapp Stewart. I was told my mixes are too clean. What do you use to dirty up your vocals? Well, with a description like too clean, that could mean a lot of different things. And don't immediately jump to distortion, because that's probably not what they mean. It could mean that the vocals are too separate from the backing track or the other instruments in the mix. It could mean that there's not enough reverb. It could mean that there's not any delays or audible effects on it. If someone told me my mixes were too clean, I would probably think that, and especially with the vocals, that they're too separate or they're not fitting the song correctly. The song's not supporting the vocals. The vocal is not fitting with the song. So probably just a simple reduction in volume for the vocal. Bring the vocal down all the way and turn it up until it sits right. And then maybe set up some parallel compression for it so that things don't get lost as well. And then check your mix at loud and quiet levels and see how that balance actually works. If this is not still fitting with the song, you can try a little bit of distortion. That parallel compression is probably gonna do a little bit of that as well, but you can do some gentle tape saturation or console saturation. Things like the Slate VCC works really well there. And try layering up your reverb. So there's a very short reverb and a slightly longer one that's mostly heard on the sustained notes, things like that. And at the end of the day, you'll probably have to do a lot of automation just to make sure that every syllable is clear and heard, and you're not just turning up everything just so that those details can be heard. You gotta make sure that it all works well. So, hope that answers your question. I think it's a bigger topic than just add some distortion, or what distortion do you use? Next question comes from Brian Martin. Any tips for running input effects versus the normal track effects in Reaper? So input effects are a way that you can apply effects and then it gets committed to that file. So whatever you record through input effects gets committed to the WAV file. It goes on the hard drive. Something that's cool to put on input effects for MIDI tracks is an arpeggiator. So you just press a single key or a chord on your keyboard, and instead of just having that chord written to the track, it actually puts in that arpeggiated sequence into the track. It's automatically synced up with Reaper, and it ends up saving you some time. I recently did a video on how to fix my broken pitch bend, and I could apply that on the input effects chain so that everything I play has that pitch bend commands totally zeroed out. If you're recording guitars, you might want to put a gate on your input effects chain. That might be a tricky thing to do it right so that it's not cutting off sustained notes and things like that. But that's kind of always a problem with guitars. Yeah, so that's all I can think of, mostly with MIDI arpeggiators or maybe things to transform the MIDI notes, and you want that to be actually visible in the MIDI editor rather than just being the monitoring path where, you know, if you're remapping notes, it may be confusing to edit something and then the effects chain is changing it later and then it's going to another instrument, all those sorts of things. So I hope that answers your question and gives you some ideas of what you can do with it. Next question comes from Eric Oakes. Is there a way to use a MIDI keyboard to trigger different functions of Reaper, muting the track, soloing the track? I did do a video on this. It's called linking track controls to a MIDI controller or something like that, where I do just that. I've got a layout with mute and solo, the basic track controls, some like last touched parameter on a knob, and I have send volume for the first four sends on that track. And depending on your keyboard, you could do momentary press actions. So I like to have the solo on a momentary button, so it's only soloing the track while I'm holding the button. And I'm talking about the MIDI controls, like the knobs and the buttons on the controller, not the actual keys. But you could assign any of these actions. Anything in the action list can be assigned to a MIDI note if you wanted. I can see that being a problem if you're playing something and then all your tracks are muting and soloing, playback starting and stopping, all those things. But if you're careful, it's something that can be done. So I'll have a link to that in the description. It's really simple to set up, but it is best if you have a controller with endless knobs, endless rotary encoders, so that you don't have to use the soft takeover mode and it just adds or subtracts to what's there instead of having to meet the original value and then being able to change it. Next question comes from Richard Domina. What are you using for tape saturation on the mix bus? Mostly I'm using the Real Bus from Tone Boosters. It's a really affordable plugin and they've upgraded it a few times since I bought it. The glue tape mode is probably my favorite. I don't usually use any of the clipping modes or the wow and flutter, things like that, and I always turn off all the noise, but the coloration that it adds is really cool. Tightens up the low end, might distort it a little bit. Mid-side controls and the saturation can kind of sweeten up the top end a little bit. I really like it. I'm not really a fan of the Slate or the Waves plugins that are doing the same thing. I like Real Bus a lot better. But that's just my opinion. Leave a comment down below about what your favorite tape saturation for MixBus is. The last question comes from Patryk Siewiera. Best tips for drum programming? The best thing I can suggest is to keep it simple. Start with your kick and snare, add in your hi-hat, and start your programming at all the same velocity. Maybe not 127, but maybe like 118 or something like that. Some upper mid range of the velocities where it's going to have a hard impact, but it's not going to be the hardest samples playing back. From there, think about what the drummer would actually play. Beats one and three are usually the harder hits, but maybe not, depending on the genre. And kind of alternate. Or use the humanize function in Reaper and you can get a lot of variations, randomness, especially with the hi-hats. You can do a lot of changes really quickly, just a few clicks. I'll usually apply about a 10% humanizing to the timing and the velocities of hi-hats, and that saves me a lot of time just manually doing it. So after you get the bulk of the song done on the kick and snare and hi-hats or the rides, depending on the section of the song, adding your crashes where they usually there's going to be a loud crash at the beginning of each section. And then after that, build out your fills, maybe go into triplet time for some of the fills, make sure that all your fills are slightly different. For harder impacts, do a flam. So essentially you're working in stages, getting the bulk of the song written on the kick and snare and hi-hats or the ride, and then you go in and add in accents, add in ghost notes, add in fills. And then you go in and humanize or manually adjust the velocities. Don't work on a one bar section for an hour, making it perfect when you should be getting the bulk of the song written and then you just fine tune it. And ideally you're not making it perfect until you have guitars and bass because all those things are subject to change. So don't stress out about making it perfect until you have a lot of the other elements of the song already there. I'm gonna put some links to some relevant videos and an ebook that I find really helpful for this topic. And that's it for this Q&A. Thank you so much for watching. Here's a list of my patrons that have pledged more than $5 per month. Thank you guys so much. It really means the world to me to be able to make money, or at least a little bit of money, making YouTube videos, educating you guys on the wonderful world of Reaper. Please subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Follow me on Facebook and Twitter. Support the Reaper blog through Patreon and visit reaperblog.net for a lot more tutorials.